Welcome to this edition of Inside Petaluma. We're on Adobe Road, just south of East Washington Street on the east side of town, 2700 Adobe Road, in front of Angelo's Homemade Jerky Sausage Smoked Meats. This is a great place if you like meat. Let's go inside. Okay, we're inside, what do you call this place, Angelo?
Angelo's Meats.
Angelo's Meats with Angelo E. Pleto. I forgot to ask the name. Yeah. But anyone who's been in Petaluma for any length of time knows that you're the sausage king and the king of other kinds of meats as well. So we're going to find out all about this institution here. If you like meat, you're going to love this show. So Angelo, Italian.
Italian.
You came to Petaluma how long ago?
45 years ago or so.
And this place has been here almost that long. More than 40 years you've been here.
Well, that making me think that I'm here probably 47 years. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
And you do meats that people can't really get anywhere else. I mean, you do it a different. You do it the old-fashioned way,
old
right?
Old-fashioned. I started by doing custom butchering, cutting, and wrap until I realized that the people they didn't raise the animal like they used to. So I figured they either go out of business or invent something else. Then I went to the smoking, catering. I opened a deli in Sonoma. And the all three businesses were so successful that the cut and wrap, it didn't fit in my schedule anymore. So I quit doing that. I do this.
Yeah, what is it about jerky? It seems like jerky is getting more and more popular
these
days.
You know, I'm glad you asked that question. I was there about 2 months in the deli business, and I was there with a couple high school girls from Sonoma. And we make a few sandwiches, but nothing to get excited. And one day I said to one girl, I said, do you know how to make a sign? Yeah, I said, why? I said, why make a sign, a cardboard box that said homemade jerky? She did, we put on the road, and the people have been stopped since.
Angelo is now cutting up pieces of jerky, and we're gonna find out the difference here, so.
Okay, let's go with this is the...
It looks like teriyaki.
Teriyaki is a part.
I'm becoming an expert at just hanging around you for a few minutes.
And this is the pepper.
That's beef, right?
Beef. And we got the hot, we got the garlic, we got the plain plain is not the right word, it's mild.
You know, the thing about teriyaki is that a lot of it is... to me, a little too sweet and sticky, and yours isn't like that.
Yeah, exactly.
Kind of overwhelming, and you don't get to taste the flavor of the meat as much as just this thick, sticky teriyaki flavor. I like peppers, so I'm going to try this
one.
You
like it?
Yeah.
If you like it, good luck.
And you just, what do you call it? Just the spicy teriyaki?
Hot
teriyaki.
I got a little story about that pepper. The first time that I made that hot pepper, being very particular on my thing. After it was on the screen, the meat on the screen, I got my shaker, and I got very close. I want to make sure that every piece I added the same amount. And all of a sudden, I must call 911. Something come up to me like I got an instant back hold. I got hot. I thought I was going to get a heart attack. And that was the stupid pepper there. I used to do pepper and teriyaki. That was my original. For years, it was pepper and teriyaki. Then I started with all this stuff here, garlic and barbecue and hot and plain and Cajun. And everything is a successful story.
But first, I want to ask you one last thing about the jerky and your customers. You give away this jerky to the troops that are serving overseas. Tell me about that.
Everything happened. I got a little jar here. A gentleman about 4 years ago, he came to buy some jerky. He said, I send it to my son in Iraq. Oh, that's very nice. And when he paid for, and I said, here, put an extra package in the bag, I said, it's from Angelo. I said, thank you. And he went out, and then all of a sudden he came back. He said, what did they do now? He said, why don't you put a jar there? It used to put a simple note to donate a buck. And the people, they've been putting money since.
Yeah.
And I got one here, one in Sonoma, and the people, they are very generous. And that is the thank you note on the door, the people, I mean, soldiers send it to me in appreciation.
Yeah. And they're all eating jerky in the pictures.
They're all eating jerky.
They say how much they love it. How about the sauces? You want to talk? You got other size things besides meat. You got the sauces and the rubs and things like that.
Well, everything comes by.
These are all your home creations, you know, your own recipes?
Yeah. This one is the garlic salsa. This is the magic they make your steak taste good or whatever. And this is the magic that make your sandwich taste better. Just to play garlic mustard with honey and horseradish.
Well, we can't go on without talking about sausage because you are the sausage king. So what is in sausage? There's all kinds of meats, but it's the peppers, the flavors, the seasoning. You know, I think of sausage kind of like hot dogs. I think of it as the scraps of meat, but it's not that, is it?
Not at all. Yeah. Not at all. Sausage is a very simple product to make if you follow the rule, the simple rule. Good meat and good spices.
Okay.
And I started with the Italian. From the Italian, then he brought me to about a dozen different flavor. I could have more, but I don't have the room to present it to people. But I'm very proud of sausage because I don't use no filling, no additive. I got two here. I got two sample. One, the two, let's say, is the two most popular.
Okay.
Is the.
That's really firm. It's not that
see?
Soft.
That show you the quality you see it. Right there, and this is the Italian, and this is called the Hawaiian Portuguese.
Mm.
You know the Italian. The Hawaiian Portuguese, they are sausage made in Hawaii by the Portuguese community.
Right.
In the state, they make linguiça.
Mm-hmm.
In the Hawaii, they make Hawaiian Portuguese.
Mm-hmm.
It's very good. It pleases everybody, and is my best seller for 20 years.
Wow.
And just to close to the Italian. The Italian, besides, I make the apple, Italian apple, the regular Italian, the hot, and the hot with fennel. I make four different smoked Italian sausage, and I make the fresh one that is not smoked.
And you grind it all right here?
I grind all the old grind. The old grind. Grind it all right there.
And you have, I'm looking at the wall behind, you have Polish sausage, every kind of sausage you can imagine.
Is the Italian spice, they are my own,
mm-hmm.
My own recipe. All the other flavor, there is a spice company in the most to be 100 United States, they make all kinds of flavor. What am I separate from the Wadam? Because then I put my 2 cents in. I taste it. If it doesn't please me, mostly they don't, then I add my own.
Okay, so it's your own unique blend that you can't get at any other kind of sauce?
No.
But can I ask you one more thing?
Sure.
So I was told that I should ask you about pork butt. Pork butt doesn't come from where it sounds like it comes from.
It comes from the shoulder.
The shoulder?
Yeah.
So why do they call it pork butt?
You know what? That question I've been asked for years and nobody ever an answer for that.
Maybe somebody was confused in the butcher shop one night and...
Yeah, because what is the end? The shoulder is the other end. Yeah, I buy 100% pork butt, my Italian sausage especially.
Okay, so two big lessons here today. First, if you're buying Italian sausage, there's no beef in it.
No beef in it.
And then the second thing that we've learned, that I've learned, is that pork butt...
Pork butt is the best part of the shoulder.
Okay.
This is the story, I believe it. Let's face it, you can, if you're hungry, a piece of bread, a glass of water will get you going.
That's true.
But make the people excited about what they eat, that's important.
Okay, we want to thank Angelo Ibletto.
Ibletto.
Yeah. I got to say it with the gusto.
Good gusto. Sir.
Okay. Angelo's Meats on Adobe Road, 2700 Adobe Road, just south of East Washington on the east side of town, next to where all the critters are outside, where all this good meat comes from. You got sausages, you got jerky, you got sauces, you got olives, you got everything going on. You're helping out the troops by donating to their cause overseas.
Their cause, yes.
And we just want to thank you so much for showing us your smoked meats and your jerkies and your Polish sausages and Italian sausages. Thank you, Angelo.
Thank you very much for being here.
Okay, that's going to wrap it up for us right here. We'll see you on the next Inside Petaluma.
Paisano,
way, paisano,
way, 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 paisano,
way, 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 paisano,
way, paisano, come sta?
Hey, paisano, how you are?
I got a friend Pasquale from sunny Italy, and he is always smiling, as happy as can be. If you should ever meet him, why, you'll be smiling too. You'll dance a tarantella when he yells out to you.
Paisano,
way, 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 paisano,
way, way, way.